How are you doing, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to more Puzzle and Dragon Sea on the Nintendo 3DS. Hopefully you are doing well. I'm doing okay myself, and recording this straight off the back of the last episode, so I mean, I'm kind of in my zone right now. I hope I'm in my zone anyway. And we'll continue on with the final level of the fifth continent, which will be the Sky Dragon of Light. Now, before we do that, we'll go through the same old procedures. Hatch these eggs. We've got a new mystery egg here, so we're going to be welcome to a brand new monster of the wood type element, and he is this. You know, he doesn't even look like a wood type, he just looks like a rock type. But I guess the little wood style chip he's got hanging around his neck definitely resembles the wood type. But yeah, pretty cool, he looks very effective. That can't really be confirmed right now. But what can be confirmed is we have another legendary egg right here before your eyes. And this one is he certainly is a beast. This guy just looks angry and awesome. Flamestar Ifrit. Alright, he looks pretty cool, but then again, the bad thing about these, I mean, we've only got one legendary type, and he's only able to go to level 30 as a maximum. I'm not even sure if he can evolve or anything like that, but level 30 is kind of a disappointment, because I would expect him to at least go to a maximum of at least 70. But then again, we've been, I don't know what the word is, but that kind of sucks. But anyway, level maximum, as you can see, 30 is a 5-star legendary monster of the water type. The one we just caught or just acquired right now is also a legendary phantom dragon type legendary as well. And as you can see, his maximum level is also 30. I'm not even sure why that is. He's level 5, damn it. I mean, he's a 5-star legendary monster. Why is it only level 30? Can these things evolve? Or are there better legendary monsters to obtain? I really, really don't know. But anyway, we're just going to skip on and get to this final dungeon, because I've been waiting for this for a long, long time, and I'm excited about this. Before we do actually go in there, I want to quickly just see this guy about the Dragonstones. Your total was 16. He wants to see 12 from us, so we'll show him that. He gives us a Sapphire Dragon Rune. We've had these before. Now we just got to show him 15 and give us a Fafnir Egg, which kind of, if I had to guess, it would be like a light type, but then again, I may be wrong. But we won't do that now, because I don't really want to dwell on that. If I get it now, then I'm going to go back to the lab and hatch that thing. So we just skip that for the next episode. For now, we're heading to the final area. I'm kind of worried about this, because the last dungeon, I kind of had a tough time. It took me around 45 minutes. To get the job done. We did make it in the end without any deaths, but it just took a long time. But anyway, so this is the Temple of Light. This is where the last of the 5 Sky Dragons is, Monkey and Sarah. We have to rescue Holy Sky Dragon Shangri-La. We'll go with Shangri-La. But yes, Syrup does his weird stuff here. Open those gates, and on we go. All right, still I am excited about this. I'm just not really expecting great things from it. But that's incredible, Syrup. Oh, this is the first time Sarah's seen that. Ha, give over. You're gonna make me blush. Okay then, let's get in that temple. Let's do this, guys. It's been a long time. This is the final Sky Dragon we have been waiting for. Oh, Yami. Wait, what's going on? Oh, Yami? Oh, did we like leave her behind in that? All right, cool. So we're up against the Kirivolt, the Kiridif, and the White Knight. They all just sound like light-type monsters, so I guess I'm going to stick with this team. But then again, do you know, I don't even know what we should do here. Do you know, I may just take 2 dark types with me. Okay, I don't even have any teams based around that, so we have to create a new team here. Okay, we got 1 dark type there, so I guess we'll go with this team and see if this is going to benefit us in any way. I mean, every time I've done this, it never has, but I mean, it should do. So, we've got 1 level 65, we've got level 48, which we probably should focus on a little bit more, but never mind. Alright, well, the key thing is, wait, what is the key thing? Oh, now I'm just unsure. Okay, I want to take 2 fire types, so we'll get rid of you. Okay, I'm just confusing myself. We're just gonna go. Alright, what's this special ability? Elite skill. Raise the attack of your monsters slightly if you clear 5 or more dark orbs at once. Alright, guys, well, I guess we'll see how this goes. Honestly, I'm not really expecting much from it, but hopefully it does make some sort of difference. And I guess we'll take changes light orbs into dark orbs that mean that probably will be useful at some point, so we'll go with that. Because in the last dungeon, we were getting a ton of light type orbs, and it was just like getting in the way. Very, very annoying, but we'll see how this goes, we'll see how this goes. Alright, not a bad first move. We'll see how this pays off. Alright, the dark type's doing their thing. Still, I'm not even sure if dark types will... I mean, it's supposed to. That's the basics to it. It's supposed to be effective against the light types, but then again, I feel it's less effective. If I just use two fire types instead of two dark types, I feel like the two fire types are going to do a lot more for me. But I guess we'll just see how this goes. I'm not going to make any judgments yet. We'll just see how this one goes and decide from there. Alright, fairly okay start. Remember, I'm supposed to be in the zone, but I'm not really showing that right now. Alright, nice. Do you know a good way to actually test this theory? We're just going to go all out dark type right now and see what it does for us. Okay, I deliberately done that, just all out dark type, and I mean it got the job done, but then again he did have limited health, so at least it killed him, that's all I can say about it. So now we'll just focus, we'll take the left hand path here, and that's where the Dragonstone lies. Remember, we've got to show 15, we've got 16, so obviously the next step may be like 18 or 20, so we need to actually at least gather a few within this episode. Come on, think. Alright, that was one huge fire combo. See what I mean? Fire just seems more effective. Orb change light. Ooh, god. Certainly not what we needed, but then again, we did prepare for this. Orb change dark. We changed those lights into darks, and this should benefit us. So, I'm pretty pleased with that. Let's see. Alright, cool. And there we go. So that move is going to definitely benefit us throughout our journey. But then again, Dragonstones. Dragonstones have been a nuisance for us recently. The last like 5 attempts we tried to get one of these, we failed every time. Clear 5 fires in the group, and then clear 5 or more combos. This one should be a lot more easier than what it has been. Do you know what? I screwed it up. Just mess it all up. Alright, I definitely screwed that one up. So we've got 2 more turns. Clear 5 in the group. I was going to focus on that one first. So that's the 5 in the group done. Now he's got a clear 5 combos in there. One more. Ugh. There we go. Finally! We've got a Dragonstone after so many attempts. Alright, that brings us to 17. Oh dear. There's been making hard work of that stuff recently. But never mind, we got it. Alright, nice. But yeah, it does give us more reason to use our skill moves because... I don't know, it's just something I kind of neglect recently. I know, I just usually build up all my skill moves and then only unleash them at the very end, at the boss battle. I mean, you earn them quite quickly, so we may as well just try and get or make the most of them at the time. Yeah, but one move you will see me using quite frequently is the orb change from light to dark, and we probably will use that in this next obstacle, which is a verse battle. Ha! I'm glad to fight our cause, for our cause, Paradox Trooper. Aha! Fire types, alright. How shall we play this one? We'll go with what I originally planned to do. Oh, Oh wait, did we get more? Oh yes, we got more. Hey, maybe these darks aren't too bad after all. It's been a pretty good start. Glory to Paradox. Glory indeed. Wait, did he just say glory to Paradox? He just lost and he's kind of celebrating something. But, okay, where are we gonna go from here? We're gonna go... Bam. 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 Okay, I just got confused there. I was looking... Where shall we go? Yeah, I'm just confusing myself there, but never mind. Ah, so you want to play like that, hey? Remember, I've got tricks up my sleeve. Here we go. Orb change. It's like the most I've ever used skill moves in one video. Yeah, I felt like we should stick with fire instead of water. But yeah, these are a pain. These enemies are a pain. Alright, cool. We just got the sweetest combo there with that dark. That's gotta be enough, surely. And there we go. Give me that egg, give me that chip, and on to the boss we go. The Kirigon chip, the Kirigon chip. I'm pretty sure we do need those, actually. Because we've had one of those monsters sitting around for a while now, and he just needs to be evolved, damn it. So, what can we do from here? Damn, I took the long route round, I didn't even match the fire. Alright, never mind. These guys, like, they don't really seem that tough. Alright, one down. And another egg! Light type eggs. This is gonna be sweet. Do you know what? Because there's another continent after this. And. Alright, I didn't even know where to go there, so we're just gonna start with that. Yeah, there's another continent after this, which I'm pretty sure is gonna be the final one where we face Dogma. I'm not sure if it's gonna be like a load of temples within it, but what we can expect is very tough stages. I remember he was talking about death orbs. It didn't explain what these death orbs are, but there will be something called the death orbs. I'm just kind of worried about those. It seems like a really cool aspect, but then again, I'm pretty worried. Dogma's got me scared here, I gotta admit that. But we'll be introduced to it pretty damn soon once we take down this stinking light type knight, which is causing me all sorts of hassle at the moment. Not really sure why, because this thing should be a walk in the park, but we've made tough work of it. Alright, come on. Flurry of blows. And we'll wrap this one up. With hopefully this. Is that going to be enough? Please tell me that's going to be enough. There we go, moving on. White Knight defeated. Okay, Mystery Egg there, which is what we just obtained through that boss battle. That's going to be a pretty cool addition to one of our teams. Then again, I did say I'm not really a fan of dark, light and dark, but then again, I guess these dark types have fared for us pretty well. Maybe the reason why is because the dark types we have acquired were from very early on in the game, and now they just kind of seem like they're useless. Oh my god, that thing we're using has just disappeared. The thing which changed light orbs to dark. Inflicts poison on all foes. Does greater damage to one foe the lower your HP is. I guess we'll stick with that. Alright, here we go. Alright, so another Dragonstone is waiting for us. Alright, not a bad first move. We've got a 5 combo in there, which was very ineffective, but still not a bad combo. man. These guys just don't want to die, do they? Orb change of light. This is where it would have been very useful. Oh, we can't even change his orbs. We got Grudge. We got Water Boost. No point using those. Okay, it really does suck. We probably have to use this turn to... It's going to be a wasted turn. The original plan was to get rid of a few of these light orbs, but then they just all came running back. So now we've got to go through that again. Alright, sweet. Finally some decent offense. As we've got the Z-Orb in there, I hope it's going to be enough to get us through this first obstacle. And it was close to enough, not quite. Still, these things aren't budging. Please die, just please die. That sounds very harsh, but damn, these things are really frustrating me. Alright, cool. And there we go. I'm confident in this one. Okay, confident has just been crushed. Now I'm going to be confident on this one. I hope. Alright, cool. And a bit of our health back. Alright, that's the first obstacle done and dusted, guys. Sorry about that. That actually took us a lot longer than I expected. But then again, things are getting a lot tough. We've got Mystery Egg once again. I'm thinking, shall we take the longer path? We probably will, which is the left-hand side. We'll go for an ordinary match. So we take one left here. We've got to take another left again to get that Dragon Stone. It's always our aim now. At first, I never really paid too much attention to them. But then, well, now I finally realize that these things are very, very important. So we try and capture them all. Alright, everyone's getting a turn here. Dragon's Lore. Oh, we took the wrong dragon. Okay, Wait, what's this? Changes Heart Orbs into Dark Orbs. That's going to be kind of useful. We got quite a few Heart Orbs as well, so I doubt we're going to die anytime soon, so we'll just go with this for now. Alright, sweet. Alright, there we go. Sorry guys, I'm just trying to fully concentrate on getting the job done. I'm just finding things slightly difficult than usual right now. I did say the last episode was pretty difficult. This one is pretty much on the same levels. We've got a clear combos, 5 or more, clear 5 in the group. Okay, we've got to wait for the water ones to come, so I guess we'll just focus on getting rid of these light ones. Oh god. That's how water's gone. Wait, can we switch in? Okay, we can't even switch anything out. We need to hope and pray that three water types just drop down out of nowhere. So for that to happen, we need to make some crazy combos. Is this crazy enough? It doesn't seem that crazy. Oh, it was close to enough. Shoot, we're missing one more. Unfortunately, we're going to fail here. Because the thing is, we've got to clear it in the group. Alright, never mind, we'll just leave it as that. And now the blue wants to drop down for us. Alright, never mind, moving on. Damn, that was pretty effective. Shoot, that was pretty effective. I don't know, everything just seems to surprise me these days. At least we got a cool water combo set up for this next battle. It looks pretty sweet. Probably won't be that good because we've only got one water type with us. Ugh. But damn, once again, I'm sitting so awkwardly. In the last video, I did complain about this as well. Because I don't sit in the chair when I'm recording on the 3DS. I'm just sitting on my bed. And, I don't know, I just get a bad back. Not the most interesting thing, but yeah, I'm just always moving around, shuffling around. trying to find that sweet spot, and I think I may have just found it. Yeah, I think that's gonna do me good for the rest of this episode. Alright, cool. Hopefully I can perform a little better as well. Orb change light once again. Damn, these things are punishing. These things annoy the hell out of me. Alright, well that's not a bad combo, I mean, especially with what we're working with. But yeah, even after all the practice I've been giving myself with the Puzzle and Dragons on the iPhone, I don't know, they play the same, but they just feel different in a way. I feel the mobile version is probably the better version in terms of content. You get the daily uploads. I think there's maybe a lot more monsters as well. But then again, I would prefer to just play on the 3DS as well. I find it a lot more easier to play on the 3DS. Playing on an iPhone is kind of difficult. Maybe on an iPad or something would be a lot more beneficial. But like on a smartphone, it doesn't really give you that freedom feel. Even though you can play it anywhere you are, it just feels like you're limited to how you perform. But yeah, once you play, you'll probably understand what I'm saying. But the game is free, so I definitely say it's worth checking out. And all right, cool. Well, all right, not bad. Ah, yes, get out of here. And here's the boss. These episodes are starting to take longer and longer. That's to be expected, alright. 9 skill points, let's see what we can do. Mega Smash, Grudge. Wait, what was Grudge again? Okay, we don't need to use Grudge. Heart change. We'll go for a heart change. We get a few more dark orbs on the field. If we can actually get an egg for one of these monsters, that would be super sweet, because these things look really, really cool. What else can we go with? Water Boost, Dragon's Lore, Mega Smash. Nope, we'll leave it as that. Oh my god, did I just... What was I thinking there? That was a hopeless move. Luckily we had the Z-Orb there to do some damage. Shining Breath. Just the sound effects they're making there, it just seems like they'd be really, really devastating moves, but they weren't really that powerful. Oh god, I took the long way. Phew, we just got the move in. Alright, that should hopefully be one down. Not quite, we're almost there. But now we need to start thinking about getting a bit of healing in there. So phew. I was panicking a little bit there. Okay, we've got a bit of healing in there. We did not get the kill, which is gonna be a bit of a problem. Ugh. Shining Breath again. Okay, we cannot die. What we got? Okay, Grudge is supposed to be effective. Alright, cool. That's one down. Then again, we've got no hearts here, which is gonna be a problem. Okay, we may as well use Mega Smash as we haven't really got anything to work with. Oh shoot, that was useless. Yes, Fire Orb, Z Orb there. That's gonna be useful. Please. Yes! Oh, we got so lucky there with that drop down. I was kinda like panicking for my life there. We had no Z Orbs, no Heart Orbs in the field. So it was literally all or nothing. Phew! Mystery Egg, another Curvolt chip, and we can move on. What we got here? Is it gonna be the final Sky Dragon dungeon? It sure is. Hall of the Sky Dragon. Alright, I'm thinking to myself, what team shall we take? I'm gonna go with the same team. I did say I was gonna switch out. Cynthia raises the attack of your dark monsters. Could be useful. I hope it's useful. We're gonna go with you, Cynthia. You better do me proud here. Because also there's like another ability with the dark type which makes your attack stronger if you make a match of 5 dark orbs or more. So we'll see how that goes for us. Alright, a very, very good first move there. Very, very good. Alright, nice. Drop down for the Z orb. And there we go. First obstacle out of the way. Maybe this one won't take that long after all. Alright, 2 verse battles before the boss as well. Jeez, this is kind of punishing. Alright, oh, Cutie with little dragon. Okay, Cutie Whittle Dragon Tamer. I hope this doesn't hurt too much. Alright, she's trying to gain that psychological advantage there. We may be small, but we are very effective. I can assure you of that. You know, he's got to back those words up. And I'm not doing a good job of that. Alright, we got a little lucky there. Alright, cool. We're back in this. But one thing which has let us down, we haven't really had any monsters with skill moves to deal some physical damage, such as the Burning Breath or anything like that. So we're kind of limited to what we can do. Alright, one down. Oh my god, that was weak. Jeez, I just expected a lot more from that. I know if it's a force for powered up pills, I was always sure they just made your attack stronger. I'm not really aware if it helps with defense or anything like that. Alright, phew, there we go. I don't know what it is, I'm kind of like hesitating on some of the moves I'm making now. This is kind of a tense moment to be in. Sky Dragon's coming on the way. Very limited on the Heart Orbs, which are dropping down. I never really have to rely on them too much, but now it seems like the time where I have to, so I've got to be very careful here. Alright, solid move. Alright, one down. But yeah, even though E3 is over, I'm still... Do you know, I'm not even that hyped because, I mean, some of the games were awesome, don't get me wrong. But I'm pretty much just happy playing what I've got already because there's a few games I need to still get through. And I'm literally in no rush to start anything else. Which is always my main problem. Okay, we'll just leave it as that. Like, I'm still in the middle of a few games and then one game will come out, then I'll just drop all of those, then start on with a new game. I hate being in that situation. And it's one I've literally been in for like the last 3 years now, so I'm just going to try and focus all my time on what needs to be played, and then when the time comes, then I'll go and get that game when I'm ready, not just get it day one just for the sake of it, because I've still got games which are still sealed up in in its wrapper, just waiting there to be played. Then we've got one game which is probably about... let me see. There's one game I've had for over a year now. I did mention this in the last video, which is Professor Layton, the Azran Legacy. I've actually had that game for over a year now, maybe a year and a half, and it's still sealed up, just sitting there. and the thing is, I've never played a Professor Layton game before, so I'm really intrigued to see how this game's going to be. And I just haven't really given myself the time to play it. So from now, I'm just going to... Okay, I mean, one game's coming out pretty soon. By the time I upload this, it'll be out already, which is the Batman Arkham Knight. Really excited about that. I mean, there are some exceptions I will make when it's a game which I'm really anticipating. Batman's definitely one of those. I haven't played every Batman game in the series, but the one I have played, okay, I've kind of played like one and a half. I played a bit of the Origins one, or at least half of it, and Arkham. Okay, which one did I actually play? I'm gonna look at my collection quickly to see which one I have. Probably Asylum. I don't know, it was on the Wii U anyway. And that's the one I did actually complete. A lot of fun, I really enjoyed that game. And which is why I'm making the exception for this Batman. Alright, I made that complicated, but yeah. Always a situation I find myself in. There we go, full health. And we're moving one step closer. Alright, please just straight to the burst battle. Don't make me do another battle before it. Oh my god, it made me. Oh, this is a tough place. Okay. May as well use some of these skill moves then. Okay, no point using that. I'll go with another Dragon's Lore. Still not really sure how much it's going to affect us, but yeah, oh well. Pulse Impact. Oh, that's new. Yeah, but I'm definitely noticing now that the dark type's really affecting us. We've got two in our team. Wait, did I just attack twice? I wasn't even paying attention there. Alright, cool, we got super lucky. Alright, there we go. Damn, this certainly is a drag. This is really tough, this dungeon. I'm literally actually sweating as well through this dungeon. Then again, I'm wearing the jumper and it's a sunny day, but anyway, I'm sick of the sight of you, I'll show you my strength. Okay, how should we go about this? Okay, fair start. Actually, we'll go with... Okay, force power pills. We don't really want to be taking any damage here, so we'll go with a Mega Smash. Wood and water, so it should be really effective. Okay, not really that effective. Damn, that's actually really weak. Jeez, why is everything so weak? Maybe those force power pills do actually make a difference. Damn it, please don't hurt me again. Oh my god, those force power-up pills are really, really a nuisance. Okay, let's just focus on some healing for now. Oh my god, these things are just... Close. At least we know it's not going to kill us. Then again, it may kill us. Ooh, that was close. Shoot. So we will literally make sure we get our health back and kill it in this turn. I think we've done the job of killing it. We haven't really got that much health back, but from now on the focus is just to heal up continuously. Because actually, we probably want one more battle before we reach the boss, because if we go straight to the boss now, that is not really going to give us much of a chance. Please, no boss. Okay, cool. Okay, everyone's going to attack in two turns, which is really useful. And I'll use this turn just to get a bit of healing in there. So we had to make that move, otherwise we were doomed. Seriously. Okay, that's a decent healing as well, a line of 5 healing. Pretty darn useful. That's one out of the way as well, so 2 to go. Okay, that's probably the best move we could have hoped for. There was actually no rush there to get the kill. Alright, cool. We're back in a very good position here. That should be another one down. It should be our health on full. And one more to go. Okay, he's going to do a bit of damage here, but then again, we can probably will focus on healing ourselves to max just before the boss. And then we'll hopefully wrap things up from there. There we go, a nice thing to finish things up. And we've got a really good combo prepared for the next battle, which is the boss battle. There we go. Time to see Amy again. This is what I was really interested about, to see how things unfold between Amy and Sarah. And now we get to find out. So here we go. Good, Sarah. I'm glad to see how far you've come still. You've got a long way to go. Just like the old days, Yami. Let's not fight anymore, Sarah. I'm not here for you. I'm after Monkey. Why? What has Monkey done to you? No answer? Then tell me, what was all that about a promise and handing things your way? Please stop, I can't say. Oi, stop being mean to Sarah. Late to the party, I see. That's fine. I'm here for you anyway, Monkey. Once I defeat you, then my duty will be done. I'm going to give you a fight you'll never forget. For I have Holy Sky Dragon Shangri-La on my side. We'll sit with that. Let's do this, Monkey. Alright, straight into things here. The Holy Sky Dragon Shangri-La. Alright, cool. This thing does look like an ultimate beast, but then again, all the Sky Dragons do. But this is definitely a pretty looking one. I think the Dark type one was probably my favorite so far. But this thing's going to attack in one turn, so we've got to be very, very careful of that. Okay, we're not going to focus on any skill moves yet. We'll just see how this goes. Okay, not the worst of starts. Oh, it's gotten itself. Okay. We'll boost our dark types, and I'm also gonna... This is a bit of a risk, because I'm not really sure how strong this guy is gonna be, but we will sacrifice some of these dark... Okay, wait a second. Okay, we've got a little escape route here, which we'll take. Okay, that's one hell of a combo. I mean, I think that's pretty good, in my opinion. Then again, we'll see how effective it actually is going to be. Remember, he did guard himself, so... Oh my god, guys, what the... Shoot! What? That's a Sky Dragon! 10,000 D-Volts, very much. And I think someone just leveled up, I'm not even entirely sure, I was just so shocked. Oh my god. I mean, that was literally... I don't know what it was, guys. I mean, I know Dark's very effective against Light. We did boost our Dark-type skill, we did make a pretty decent combo of Dark. So yeah, I mean, I don't know, I'm just really surprised that we actually got the kill in one hit there. But you won, Monkey, but I had the Sky Dragon on my side. When it's over, I'm sorry, Sarah, I won't be able to keep my promise. What is the promise, Yami? Hold on. Nyx here? Now who is this guy? The hero, that's who. What? Thank goodness. That can't be. Is that Saya? But how? I never break a promise, Sarah. What's this cat got to do with anything? This little cutie is Saya, the very same cat that Yami and I loved when we were children. What, they know each other? Saya was a feral cat who lived in the park near where we learned swordplay. We fed Saya every day. One day Saya vanished, we couldn't find her anywhere. I cried day and night. Finally Yami told me. I promised to find Saya no matter what, but I never did, no matter how hard I tried. But then Enigma turned up half a year ago, and he claimed he found Saya. But he said I'd never see that cat again unless I joined Paradox. No Yami, that's why you joined? I'm sorry Sarah, I couldn't do it to myself. But I'm glad to see that you've fallen in with a good group of friends. Now goodbye. Come with us, Yami. Never. Not after the pain I've caused you and your friends. I couldn't live with myself. Not after handling everything so poorly. I'm sorry, Monkey and Syrup. Well then. Oh, Yami. Amy? Sarah? Okay, probably not the twist I was expecting, but that was still kind of cool. Very weird, definitely did not see that one coming, but you are the ones that saved me. You have my thanks. Here, take this Dragon Jewel. And guys, remember this is the last Sky Dragon, but things will not be ending here. I'm pretty sure there's going to be one more major battle for us to at least accomplish. But acquire the Dragon Jewel of the Holy Sky Dragon. Your skill gauge matchman has gone up. You can now register 8 monster teams. This is amazing, Monkey. That's all the Sky Dragon jewels. Acquired all of the Dragon jewels of the 5 Sky Dragons. Getting all of the Dragon jewels is a major accomplishment for a Dragon Tamer. In fact, that makes you a Dragon Master. You're truly amazing, Monkey. I like all this cheery music, it makes me feel good inside. But you're now officially a Dragon Master. Congratulations, Monkey. You've grown into an excellent Dragon Master. That would be something to stop and celebrate under normal circumstances. But you must face Dogma. He wills a power greater than ours, the Sky Dragon of Death. Thus to counter Dogma, you must wield the power of the Sky Dragon of Life. Zerklia? Zerklia? The Sky Dragon of Life, yes. The Divine Life Dragon Zerklia. All will be revealed, Monkey, when you are accepted by the Sky Dragon. Then the Divine Life Dragon Zerklia will show his true form. But where can we find the Sky Dragon? Well then, surely the captain will want us to head to the Nightmare Castle Avalon. Yeah, we can't just wait around. Let's report back to HQ, Monkey. Damn, so maybe we get another continent. Wait, there always was another continent, but I just thought it would be like Dogma's kingdom. But it looks like it's going to be another little kingdom before we face Dogma, so kind of cool. So we've cleared all 5 of the main ones so far. And the 6th one should be unlocking for us. But yeah, it's been a good journey so far. I hope you guys have enjoyed this. And there it is. Damn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then you got the main one. So that main one's probably Dogma's lair, you would assume. But yeah, I have no idea what to expect in this place, but I just know it's going to be really, really tough. So I better be extra prepared for this. I'm going to be doing a bit of grinding before I do make the next episode. So I mean, I'm kind of like ahead on episodes right now, so I should be ready by the time this episode does upload. But anyway, the Shangri-La area is back under our control. Syrup Monkey, Sarah, Nick, good work. Each of you has unique talents, and in working together, you fought off this latest threat. You've all grown into formidable dragon tamers. I couldn't be prouder. But I fear the worst is ahead of us. For now, you must brave the Avalon area. If only we could reach it by sea, but Avalon is surrounded by vicious something. You must go by land, unfortunately, and there is only one route. The Gates of Doom. I'm afraid so. When the land was joined together, it formed a passage through the crags. The land beyond the Gates of Doom is the Avalon area. Your first step will be the Underworld Forest. Central Dogma are stationed in the Avalon area. There are a group of dragon tamers directly under Dogma's control. Now you see why this will be your toughest mission yet. You'll need to focus like never before and complete the mission at all costs. But before you go, Monkey, I must offer my most heartfelt congratulations. Dragon Master, go to the storeroom on the first floor. I've had it unlocked. You've earned what's there. The storeroom on the first floor. Do you know what? I've never even heard of the storeroom. I guess we'll do this now, because I'll probably forget about it by the time the next episode does come around. So, is this the way? I hope so. Okay, that's not it. It was our autograph. Do you know what, guys? Okay, cool. I wasn't even aware of this place, but let's see what we've got inside. Acquired a monster egg. Now, what we got here? A wildfire dragon. Gaybold chip. Alright, cool. And we also have... what the hell? The Oyamatsumi chip. Alright, cool. Was this the gift he was talking about? I don't even know if this is the right floor. But there's a few more things to be acquired. Do you know what? I don't even think... this may have been open to us from the get-go. I really don't know. Metal Dragon's rune. The Metagon chip. Maybe this stuff was actually... okay, I'm pretty sure this stuff was available from early on. But maybe this entrance here, which we just went through, was probably something which has been recently unlocked. Okay, let's get out of here. I'm going to quickly talk to Watari again, just in case. Because I really don't know. This definitely wasn't the first floor, because we're still on the same floor. Let's see. Maybe we actually did do it. Alright, well, I guess we'll wrap things up there. Hope you guys did enjoy this one. If you did, please show your support as you have done so far throughout our journey. I really do appreciate the support. And this is just like a training area. So yeah, I guess we'll wrap things up here. So until next time, have a great day. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you all in the next video. See ya!